This is my kitchen. And this is my new smart backsplash with built-in kitchen timer and visual indicators. When it was time to add a backsplash, I wanted to take the opportunity to make it a little bit more interactive and integrated with my home automation. The first thing you will notice is this LED strip. It acts as a timer and a visual indicator to show the status of some of my appliances. The middle portion of the LED strip is a timer. I used a blue LED to represent 10-minute intervals and a white LED to represent 1-minute intervals. So this is 11 minutes, 12, 13, and so on. The corner LEDs are used as status indicators. I can customize it to use any color or flashing pattern for a given appliance. For example, a solid red LED indicates that the cooktop is on, and a flashing LED means the air circulation is on. I interact with the backsplash in three ways: over MQTT messages, so command messages to control, and status messages for updates. This is very useful because it allows easy integration with home automation systems. The second way is by using the built-in web interface. I can adjust the timer or read the status indicators here. The third way is using buttons on the controller to adjust the timer or turn on the nightlight. The controller has a buzzer, so when the timer is up, you hear this. Now let's rewind and see how I build this. At first, I wasn't sure where to position the LED strip in my kitchen. I thought of placing it towards the bottom section of the wall, but that would require over 100 LEDs and would have taken too much space. Then I thought of placing it in the corner, but it would have been too far from the cooktop. Then I found this perfect spot. It's close to the cooktop and it blends with the look of the tiles without being too noticeable. Since this is a permanent setup, I wanted to be sure the LED channel will not move and break the grout, so I drilled a 4-hole for attachment. I tried to align the holes with the studs and used big anchors when that was not possible. I used 4 long screws with flat head to fix the LED strip to the wall. I then added the plastic cover to protect the channel. I continued applying tile adhesive and placed the tiles all the way to the top. While waiting for everything to dry, I cut the LED strip to the right length, which is just over 3 feet. Added end wiring and secured it with heat shrink. I drilled into the cabinet, fished the wires to the other side, and placed my LED strip in the aluminum channel. And so far, it's looking really good. To test my LED setup, I made this prototype using D1 Mini and loaded it with a project called WLED. And again, everything looked fine. Now it was time to build my custom controller. I designed this board using ESP12 module, 3 buttons, a light sensor, a connector for the LED strip, a buzzer, a 3.3 voltage regulator, and pinouts to program the ESP module. I then moved on to design the PCB layout. I chose a long rectangular shape so it would easily fit under the cabinet. One thing I learned from previous boards I designed is to make sure the area around the antenna is not covered with copper, or else the range suffers dramatically. Okay, that looks good. Time to send it for fabrication. I downloaded the Gerber file and placed my order on PCBWay, who is also the sponsor of this video. And of course, I picked my favorite color and added stencils to my order. And after 2 weeks, I got my PCBs and the stencil. It is time to build the controller. I applied the soldering paste using the stencil. I placed the capacitors, resistors, voltage regulators, buttons, and the ESP12 module. I chose the 0805 SMD size because this is the smallest size I feel comfortable soldering by hand. And then it was reflow time. I then added the through-hole components. And the controller was assembled. For the software, I wrote a custom firmware using the Arduino IDE. The main parts to highlight are the LED setup, the loop that handles all the interactions, and the custom effect for the kitchen timer. Flashing the code was very easy using the FTDI adapter and the pinouts in the controller. I don't have to put it in programming mode or hold down any buttons. Just click and done. I also designed a case for the controller. I plan on printing it once my 3D printer arrives. We are almost done here. I connected the LED strip to the controller using the block terminal. And fixed the controller under the cabinets. Then I got a really long power extension and ran the power from the top of the cabinets down a gap between two cabinets and straight to the controller. And now I have a smart backsplash in my kitchen. Once I integrate this with my home automation system, the real fun will begin. So that's it for me. Thanks for watching, and feel free to ask any question you have in the comment section about my project. Peace!